Hey y'all, it's Labachi here, bringing you another Mario video. Today, I want to talk about the 10 things I want to see in the Mario 35th Anniversary Remasters. Obviously, these games haven't come out, so this is only speculation on my part. I can see a couple of these getting in, but the rest, honestly, serve as my wish list of sorts. Anyways though, I digress. Let's get on to the video. Quick, don't forget to sub and hit the bell icon if you enjoy Mario content and want to see more in the future. The first thing I can see being added in is online. This is a no-brainer, and this is my reasoning for why they are taking long to announce it. Now, the type of online could vary. I, and many others I'm sure, would want the online to be a full-fledged multiplayer experience, with you being able to tack on entire games with a friend or against a friend. My vision includes this being with 4 friends, but how cool would it be if online let you play with up to 8 people? How about 12? It would be mayhem, yes, however, I'd argue they already did it in 3D World. Remember the double cherry? And even though it's not a platformer, Smash Bros. An 8-player mode does seem like a lot and unconventional, but it's not a lie that it can be so stupidly fun. Not to mention, I'm sure Nintendo saw the popularity of Super Mario 64 online before they shut it down, a ROM hack of Mario 64 that lets you play with up to 24 people. Knowing Nintendo though, we will only get online leaderboards and Luigi Balloon time again. Number 2 on the list has to go to local multiplayer. It's no secret that a selling point of the Nintendo Switch is that you can play together, so it would definitely be something if they took those original games and added in full-fledged co-op. No, nobody wants girlfriend or little sibling mode like they did in Odyssey. I'm talking full ability to control another Mario Brother or a Mushroom Kingdom citizen, which gets me on to my next point. Playable characters, that's right, I want to see something like 3D World, as do many others. Imagine getting to traverse Bomb-On Field as Toad or Toadette, defeating Petey Piranha with Wario, even imagining Flood trying to lift them up is funny. Don't even get me started on Galaxy and how cool it would be to see Rosalina herself flying across galaxies with her Lumas. Mario is fun and all, but the Mario universe itself has a cast of characters we almost never get to see outside of the car and party games. Another thing I want to see is different power-ups. The flower power-up in Super Mario 64 DS was a new addition to that game. It let Mario turn into a big balloon to get anywhere. Yoshi would spit hot fire, Luigi would turn invisible, and Wario would turn into metal. The latter two, Mario himself could do in the original, but the former two were neat additions to the game. They didn't have to add those at all, but the fact that they did just adds this neat uniqueness to the game that we remember. So, I think they could add in a couple extra new power-ups to each game. Maybe a new blaster type in Sunshine, or a new type of mushroom in Galaxy. One example I could give for Sunshine could be a new blaster that lets you create a water bomb of sorts to let you clean areas quicker. For Galaxy, I mean they could literally add anything. They have a mushroom that turns you into a literal spring. But if I were to be in charge of it, I would add a frog mushroom to give you the frog suit from Mario Bros. 3. This will let you traverse water levels faster and obviously jump higher. The next thing I could see them adding in is extra modes like they did for Super Mario 64 DS. I mean, who else didn't get addicted to gambling because of Luigi? Those minigames didn't even have to be in, but the fact that they were just added to the replayability of the game. On top of this, I would like to see the obvious add-ins like a gallery mode in a sound studio, a place where you could listen to the sweet and succulent OSTs from Koji Kondo and Mahito Yokota. Also, we could not forget the obvious addition of a traditional hard mode. Whether that be a new game plus or a straightforward choice, I'd like to see it. Some people, including myself, just find Mario games too easy. Adding in some extra optional challenge would be a neat treat for veterans of the platformer genre. There's not much to really say about this one besides the obvious. Like Super Mario All-Stars of the past, I want this game to include an extra level or two. I've talked about how in the first All-Stars they added in the Lost Levels, or the original Mario Brothers 2 as they call it. Now what if they did that with this collection? What if there is a galaxy or painting from 64 that didn't make the final cut? It doesn't have to be a whole new section, but an extra themed level or mission would be nice. Fixes. Yes, I want to see some fixes to the camera, gameplay, and glitches. These games are notorious for having bad camera placements sometimes, especially Sunshine. This is something that isn't even hard to believe that they would do, just fix the buggy cameras. Which honestly is probably the most likely thing to come out of this list. Another thing I want to see is a time mode. Remember in New Super Mario Bros. U where they added in a series of levels that you had to beat the time and set new records? Probably not, but I think they should add it into this, mainly because it's a simple way to add replayability to the game. Online leaderboards could even be added to see who completed a level the fastest. I'm sure it would be a heated competition for first place. Last but not least, I would like to see DLC, like Mario Maker 2, where they added in a bunch of free updates as time went on. Maybe they can remaster 3D Land and add it in for an extra $20. I would definitely buy it. But let me know what you guys think. What do you see making the cut for these fabled remasters? Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy Nintendo speculation, or just Nintendo content in general. I make a lot of it. Like if you like, and dislike if you dislike. I will see you next time.